Hey, welcome back to World Sport as we continue our build-up to the Champions League final. And let's take you straight out to Porto, where we're going to be joined by the AP's global sports correspondent, Rob Harris, at the game, along with some 12,000 fans, although perhaps there's more than that in the city. Rob, it still feels kind of weird to have supporters at sports events. How would you describe the atmosphere there today?
Yeah, it's so unusual here in Porto to have just so many fans who've travelled in. It's something we haven't really seen in Europe for more than a year. Most stadiums are being closed. When I was in Portugal last August for the Champions League final, it was an empty stadium. And finally, football's starting to feel a bit like football again. And it's not only crowds coming to games, but even just people getting out of England, which hasn't been allowed until recently. So this is a real chance not only for fans to enjoy themselves at a game, but finally to enjoy the sun and to escape some of the grim depths of the pandemic. And here they are in a Champions League final, the first time ever for Manchester City fans and just the second time for Chelsea.
Both these sets of fans support teams that play in blue. Looking at the pictures we've just been seeing on the screen, I think they're all going to be sunburnt and looking like red lobsters by the end of the day. Rob, in recent years, a trend has been developing in this competition. Premier League teams are really asserting themselves on the continent. Five of the last eight finalists have been English, and these two in particular have very deep pockets. I know you've been writing about this subject. Is there more to their success than just their vast resources?
I mean, it's undoubtedly, particularly in this pandemic congested season, that the depth of the squads has enabled two of Europe's wealthiest sides to reach the final. They have the resources to be able to cope with what's been such a demanding season. And yes, Manchester City, for them, this is really the pinnacle so far of their 13-year journey since the Abu Dhabi investment began to flow into the club. And of course, at Chelsea, you've got Roman Abramovich's billions since 2003. We are expecting him to be at this game in Porto tonight. He's not been able to go to games in England over the last couple of years due to visa issues. And we are really seeing the strength of English football asserting itself. Of course, no English sides are in last season's final, but here we do have two of the biggest sides. And of course, the extra subplot to all of this is these are two of the clubs who are part of the ill-fated attempts of a European Super League breakaway just a few weeks ago. They wanted to leave the Champions League, but these two were amongst the first to collapse the project by pulling out and committing to UEFA and existing structures, while you've still got Barcelona and Real Madrid and Juventus clinging on to that breakaway. So it's all sets itself up to be a pretty interesting final, and we've got almost 6,000 fans from each of the side. You can hear Chelsea fans near me here in the square chanting for Timo Werner, the striker who's perhaps not been scoring the goals as expected this season, but obviously a stage for him to deliver tonight at the end of his first campaign with Chelsea.
Yeah, we're all set for what should be a really great game. Rob Harris, looking forward to it. Thanks very much. So that is the view in Porto. We've already been to Manchester. We're going to take you to West London next, where one club has already hit the jackpot today. We'll tell you about that and discuss whether Chelsea can make it big as well.